So today I'm going to be sharing with you my hits and misses for the month of July. I have so many hits and I have quite a few misses as well, so I can't wait to share them with you. So the first thing I want to talk about that is a hit is off the shoulder tops. I have been so obsessed with them this month. It is just insane. So I figured I would show you two of my favorites. This is one I actually just wore in my last video that I filmed, but this is from Nasty Gal. I love ones that cinch at the waist like that. It is kind of see-through, so you have to wear pasties or whatever, but it is so cute. It has those long sleeves, so you could wear this into the fall and winter if you wanted to. It has this ruffle detail, which is just so pretty. So I got this one from Nasty Gal. It's one of my favorites. And then this one is new, but I had to share it with you guys because it's adorable. I got it from Intermix, and this is what it looks like. Isn't it just adorable? It's wrinkled. It has little tassels all the way in the front and the back. I just love this one. It's so cute. It fits so well. And yeah, again, it is from Intermix. It is pricey. I don't want to discuss price, but it is so cute on. I just love it. Then I want to quickly talk about this. This is kind of random, but one of the things you probably don't know about me unless you watch some old vlogs of mine is I get a Brazilian wax. The main reason why I do that is because I hate shaving my bikini area. I get the worst razor burn ever, like, and the worst ingrown hairs. It just sucks. So I've been getting Brazilian waxes since probably 2014 or so. It's been a while, maybe even 13. I can't even remember when I first got it done, but I've been getting them done forever now, and I will not turn back. But one of the things I've been really loving is these Bliss ingrown eliminating pads. Even though I do get waxes, sometimes I do get ingrown hair, but this honestly has made my bikini line look really good. I'm so shocked at it. There's 50 pads in here. Yeah. And I've used so many. I use them every time I get out of the shower. I just take one pad and wipe it on my bikini area. And honestly, you're good to go. I love it. I know Sephora used to sell Bliss, but I don't know if they still sell them now. I also loved their facial hair remover. I need to get some more of that because I loved it for my stash, because we all got a stash, let's be real. But I loved it for the top of my lip because it didn't hurt and it got all that hair off. Just can't find it anymore. If you're like me and you just get ingrown hairs really easily, I would definitely recommend this because this has literally been a lifesaver and I swear by it. I love it so much. The next product I want to talk about is a candle, and I actually have diffusers as well that go with this. I really love it. It's by the brand Nest. This one is cedar leaf and lavender, and I also have the ocean one, ocean mist or something like that. I'll leave them down below. I love the candles. I mainly just really love the scents. The candles are really nice, and I do love the diffusers, but I wish it just made the whole room smell really good. Like, I don't know if I should buy another diffuser to help really get that smell to be nice and potent, but let me know your diffuser tips down below in the comments, because I'm a new diffuser user. I'm new to diffusers, so let me know your tips and what I should do, because they're just not smelling up the whole room like I want. I just want the whole room to smell so good. So moving on to hair care, I wanted to try something new this month. As you guys know, I use high-end mostly all the time, pretty much all the time, unless I'm traveling, and then I'll go in and I will get a drugstore shampoo and conditioner, just because there's really no point if you're traveling to have a high-end conditioner and shampoo. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not gonna go buy one. I'd much rather buy a drugstore. But Garnier reached out to me and wanted me to try their shampoo and conditioner. Over the years, I have used Garnier and I love them, so I knew I wanted to try these products out. So the ones that I purchased, I went to Target to get these, by the way, and I got the big size. This is the Garnier Fructis Fortifying Shampoo Sleek and Shine 3-Day Sleek for Frizzy, Dry, Unmanageable Hair. And we all know Georgia, the South, it's humid. It's humid and gross. And there's no helping that. But I really like the shampoo and conditioner. I don't wash my hair often. I wash it probably once or twice a week. I have been using this and I love it. I can always tell when a shampoo is good, because if I'm in the shower and my hair is soft after I rinse out the shampoo, I'm like, yes, this is my kind of party, and that's what this does to my hair. So after I rinse out the shampoo, my hair is nice and smooth, and just, I don't know, when I feel the silkiness after I shampoo my hair, I just know it's gonna be a good day. Like, that's when I know I've got a good shampoo. So I love this. This smells amazing. The same with the conditioner. It leaves your hair really nice and soft. These are very affordable. I think they were like $5 or $6 at Target. Today was actually hair washing day and I used it, and you can see it's just really shiny. I don't have any frizz going on, and since I went lighter with my hair, sometimes my hair gets a little bit more more frizzy, but I didn't even take a straightener to my hair. Like, this is just the shampoo and conditioner blow dried. Like, I don't even know how to do a blowout. I'm not that talented. And I think the reason why this makes my hair so shiny is it does have argan oil in it from Morocco, and it also has apricot in it. So it really just makes your hair so shiny and soft. The argan oil just does wonders. Argan oil is so good for you. Then I've also been putting in the Sleek and Shine leave-in conditioning cream. I love leave-in conditioners. Like, they're my favorite. If there's like a nice creamy leave-in product from a brand, I will use it because that's just one of my favorite things to use on my hair. This is really great because it has the same argan oil and everything in it, and it really gets into the strands and smooths it all down. Just so your hair doesn't get really frizzy throughout the day. And I love the packaging of this. I don't know why, but I feel like this packaging is just so cute. I don't know. But I keep this on my little mirror where I keep all my hair products, and I'll just put probably, I would say, I put about a nickel size amount, and all I do is I put it from my ears down. I never put product near my root because my roots do get really oily very easily. So I always put product from here down. And then I also use this on the very, very ends of my hair where it's really dry and brittle. And this is the anti-frizz serum from them as well. This is a pretty intense product. I wouldn't put this like all over your hair. If you're like me and your hair gets super oily, I would just focus this on the very ends of your hair, and you only need a pea size amount. Like, a little bit of this stuff goes a long way. And then I will also take just a little bit right here around the edges of my face because these pieces sometimes get left out, so I like to come in here and put a little bit of that serum on my hair as well. And that's all I do. It's what I did today, and I absolutely love it. I haven't had to straighten it or anything, and I've been outside running errands before filming videos, and it just looks so good. So I highly recommend it if you're looking for more of an affordable brand. I definitely wanted to try it out for you guys because I know not everybody wants to go out and spend $30 on a shampoo. It's ridiculous. I know that. And this is super convenient, and you can get it at any drugstore. So thanks to Garnier for partnering with me and letting me try these products out. I wouldn't mention these products to you guys if I did not think that they worked and I didn't use them on myself. I highly recommend them if you have a problem with frizzy, dry, damaged hair. That's what I've got since I've went lighter, and honestly, these are amazing. Next thing I quickly want to mention is a body spray or perfume I've been using, and it's by Jo Malone. It's the Peony and Blush Suede scent. I have purchased the body butter of this before. It was a long time ago, and I love that just because I love floral. I love peony. I love roses. I love it all. I just don't want it to smell too mature. You know what I'm saying? So this is like perfect for me. I don't think this lasts forever. I mean, let's be real. I don't think it's like a super long wearing perfume, but I feel like you could drench your body in this and it's not too much. Like, it just smells so good. I love it. So if you love florals and peony smells, you would definitely need to check this out. Okay, and then I think that is it for fashion, body, hair, and everything. So now we're gonna move on to makeup. First thing for makeup that I want to talk about that was like a standout product to me this month is the Maybelline Superstay Better Skin Skin Transforming Foundation. I love this foundation. You can see I've used quite a bit of it. It just looks so beautiful on the skin. It minimizes the look of your pores. It keeps you nice and matte throughout the day. The powder, I don't have the powder on me right now. It's in my purse, but that's amazing with this as well. It's amazing with any foundation. I love that Better Skin powder. It's a medium to full coverage. I love it with a beauty blender. I love it with a brush. Speaking of brushes, one of my favorite brushes to apply it with is this It Brushes for Ulta, and it's the Airbrush Essential Bronzer. You can just blend this in so quickly. It's amazing. I love this. New favorite drugstore foundation by far. It doesn't oxidize on me. It doesn't rub off throughout the day. It's very long lasting and one of my favorites. And it has a pump. You can't beat that. And then to go along with that, I've obviously been loving the Better Skin Concealer. If you guys want to see these two products in action and the powder, I will leave that video down below for you guys. I did a full video showcasing these products because I love them so much. And yeah, I actually went out and bought the medium shade in the concealer, and I really like it. It's full coverage, blends out very nicely, and looks great with any foundation. I love it. Next up is a Tarte blush that I purchased over the month. This is the Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Blush in Risqué, and I believe this is the newest one coming out for their fall collection. I saw a bunch of stuff online at Ulta for Tarte, and I purchased all of it, mainly like the new lip products they had, but I also purchased two blushes, and I really like this one. I have it on right now. It's nothing too intense. It's just a nice pinky neutral color, as you can see right there. I just love this because it's one of those colors that can go with any look, and these 12-hour blushes are phenomenal. They last for such a long time. So this is one of my new favorite colors. I love it. Oh, look at that color. It's just so pretty. Next up, I want to talk about a translucent setting powder. This is the Kat Von D Lock It setting powder in translucent. See? You get 0.67 ounces, comes in a jar like this. I think it's very pretty, very sleek. It's not too in your face. And I just really love this powder. It sets the face really nicely. It doesn't put out too much product, so I like that because it's not too messy. I love translucent powders even if they are messy, but it's nice that this one isn't. And it lasts on the skin for such a long time, and it just really sets that concealer, and it never looks cakey. So shout out to Kat Von D because this is awesome. I've also been trying her concealer out. I don't know what I think of that yet, but I will keep you guys updated. Next up, I want to shout out this Anastasia Beverly Hills Kristen Lip Gloss. I purchased this a while back, I believe, but this has been a color I've been topping over everything. I love it. It's just so pretty. I don't have it on right now because I just did a dupes video, but I mean, this could possibly be a dupe. The product I have on my lips could be a dupe for this, but this is what it looks like. It's very pigmented and pretty. You can use it by itself, or you can use it on top of lipsticks. It's amazing, and it lasts for such a long time. It's not sticky, and it feels really good on the lips. Next up, we have this Essence Contour Powder. It has a bronzer and a highlighter, and I love this. This is amazing. The contour powder is perfect. It's really light. You can't even see it on my hand when I swatch it, but honestly, you will see it on your face. It's one of those powders where you have to apply it to really see that contour. And the highlight shade is beautiful as well. I really enjoy this highlight shade. I think it's gorgeous, especially for the money. You can see it right there. It just has a really nice sheen to it. Okay, so these eyeshadows are launching August 1st, and they are from NARS. I love these. They sent them in PR, and these are my two favorites and the two that I think you should have in your life. This one is in Pygar. It's like a silver green, and this one's in Earthshine. I used this one in one of my videos. It was the pizza highlighter video, and this is what I had on my eyes, and I loved it. It's so pretty. I definitely want to film that look. And then this is in a Get Ready With Me that you guys will see very, very soon. Or if you've seen it now, I don't know. I have so many videos to edit. I feel like swatching them doesn't really do any justice. They are so pretty, but once you put them on the eyes, they're even better, especially if you use Fix Plus. I just am obsessed with them. So they're the two right there. The Pygar one, this silver green, is going to be so pretty for fall. I used it with a deep brown lip color, and I just loved it. Last thing I want to mention is this Tarte Tartist Contour Palette. I've been using this a lot, but mainly for one shade, and it's the 3 and 4 shade. I do like this blush. I've used it before. I haven't used these highlight shades yet, but I love this color because it's the perfect mid-tone brown. I think it's amazing. This is a great palette to travel with. You have so many different shades, and you can do so many different things with this. You can use it as eyeshadow. You can use it all over your face, whatever you want it to do. I love the packaging as well. I think it's amazing with the really big mirror. The powders in here that I've tried are so nice. They're very creamy. They blend really well. And I think this is great for light to medium skin tone. But if you're medium to deep skin tones, I would definitely go with the one that Makeup by Shayla collabed with Tarte to make. It's like this, but it is deeper for obviously deeper skin tones. And I've heard it's amazing and just as great as this. But I love this one. If you're light to medium skin tone, you would definitely enjoy this. And then I really quickly want to shout out my extensions. I know you guys have heard me talk about this so much on Snapchat and Instagram, but I'm just obsessed with the color. That's what made me go lighter with my hair this month. If you guys didn't know, I did go a little bit lighter. And it's my Foxy Locks extensions in Honey Spice. They are absolutely amazing. You guys know I love Foxy Locks. I always have a coupon code down below in the description box if you want a free gift with purchase. I don't promote any other hair extension brand because this is the extension brand that I'm obsessed with and that I think is worth your money. They're very thick. They last a long time. They hold a curl. They just look absolutely amazing, and they're 100% worth every single penny that you spend on them. I'll have all the information down below. I don't have any in my hair right now, but these are just so good. Alright, let's get to the misses. The first one is this Tarte sponge. I don't know, what is this, like a shape sponge? I forget what they call this. I got this, I had such high hopes for it. I thought it was going to be absolutely amazing, but this is such a dud. This is such a stiff sponge. I did not enjoy applying my concealer with it whatsoever. I didn't even enjoy baking with it. It was terrible. Even when you put it underwater. I've tried this wet and dry. Both ways are just terrible. Even when you wet it, it doesn't expand or anything. It's just such a stiff sponge. This just was a no-go for me. I don't like it, and I don't like the tip at the bottom. I don't like anything about this, so sorry Tarte, but that was terrible. This is the Revolution by Makeup Revolution Pro Illuminate Powder. And I had high hopes for this just because I love Makeup Revolution, but this highlighter didn't do anything for me. It doesn't really have that great of a sheen to it, and it's very chalky And it looks really pretty when you swatch it, yes, but when you feel it, it just separates and it's just chalky and it just doesn't blend very well. It's just one of those products that I'm not very impressed with, so I would have to pass on this. This is a miss for me. Okay, so that's all the hits and misses, and now we're moving on to my favorite part, which is music. And I think I have something to show you. I can't remember, but I think I have something to show you. I know, oh my god. Okay, I love this song called Catch and Release. You guys, it's so good. One of the main reasons why I love Spotify is like sometimes when I'm filming like a tutorial or something, I'll just put on a random playlist and that's when I find some of the best songs. And I'm obsessed with this song.
Day to day, I'm blind to see and find how far to go. Everybody got the reason. Everybody got the way. We're just catching and releasing what builds up throughout the day. It gets into your body.
Just something about that song, it gets into my soul and just puts me in such a good mood. So definitely check that out. I also love What They Want by Russ.
What they want, what they want, what they want. Dollar signs, yeah, I know it's what they want. Yeah. What they want, what they want, what they want. Y'all ain't fooling me at all. I've been at this shit for 9 years. Now they start.
Next one is Mother Right by 2 Chainz. It's the remix. I love this song. This is like my song when I'm going to the gym right now. If I just need to get a little groove on because I have my pre-workout, this is it.
Somebody told me this gonna be your favorite song. Ooh, where that red one? That my favorite thong. Put them on. I said, baby, put them on. I said, what you gonna do?
This one's from Little Uzi Vert. It's called You Was Right. Something about this song as well just makes me like hyped up.
Yeah, alright, alright, alright. You was right, I was wrong. Yeah, I should've never ever took her home.
No.
Yeah, I should've just bombed. Yeah, fantasy on my phone.
This is one I want to mention to you guys. The first time I had it playing was on my Snapchat and I was showing like my protein I was using. This song is called Heaven and it's by Jake Owen. It's one of my favorite songs. It's been around for a little bit, but it's such a good song. I highly recommend it if you love country. If you haven't heard it, where have you been? But still check it out because it's good. I've been listening to a lot of Pandora, where it's Kit Moore radio on Pandora, and I love it. And honestly, I just cannot get over the song Magic. It's just so good. It's from his Wild One CD, and it's just amazing.
Baby, that was smoke and mirrors, and this is you and me. I don't know what to think.
I know I've mentioned that song like last year, but honestly, when it comes on, I'm just like, boom, oh. Okay guys, so I'm sorry for the crazy ending. This is terrible. I know, I'm so sorry. I cannot find the footage where I ended this video, but I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you haven't checked out my previous videos in my vlog channel, you can click on the videos right here. I hope you guys enjoyed this again. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.